All right, while we're waiting here in the parking lot and I'm not driving, I figured I could go over some of the functions on the monitor for you. So this here, we're gonna click this menu button here, and then you have volume, pairing, picture. I'm sure you guys can read, so I'll stop. But I don't know what picture does, so let's click on it. Oh, okay, cool. We know we can adjust the brightness, the contrast, the color, and I can turn my LED cam lights on and off, which is pretty sweet. Let's see what else we got. Mirroring, mirror. What is this? Holy smokes! We're upside down. And we're upside down backwards. That's pretty cool. I love that you can do that. I don't know why you would use it, but I love it. Gotta have your options. Let's see, Q mode. What is this? Okay, that's if you got several different cameras, you can split the screen into which cameras you want them to. That's pretty awesome. If we had more than one camera, I could see myself using that. Parking lines. Okay, parking lines. Okay, we can turn them on and off, and then within your different cameras that you might possibly have, you can switch through them and that. Record. Oh, wow. I do love this aspect of the Haloview's BT7. There's a little small SSD chip reader right in here. Look, someone's coming behind us. For recording. So if you wanted to record, because this is not just a backup camera, it's also a monitor that you can use for recording. So that's pretty awesome. I love that.
Yeah.
And then play. I guess this would be if you recorded something and then watch it. Yeah. So there you go. Just a little split overview of all the options inside of the camera. You're welcome. All right, so with this backup camera, there is actually, if I were to go to back and show you the camera, there's actually notches on the backside of the camera that allow you to adjust it up and down. Therefore, if you're in traffic, like heavy traffic, and you wanna watch what's behind you, then I would tilt the camera up a little more. That way I can see everything behind me. When I'm parking, obviously I would tilt the camera down just enough to see the spare tire on the back of the camper. That way, when I'm backing up, I know how close I can get to it because the spare tire is the furthest thing away from the camper.